Hi, my name is Andrew ZH, professional MotoGP 21 racer and 2019 MotoGP Esports World Champion. You have been playing MotoGP 21 for a good week or two, so I think it is definitely time to show you the best setup to turn your bike into the absolute fastest one on the grid. Before we start, it is important to know one thing. MotoGP 21 is much of the same for season by fanatics, but as with every passing year, some things have changed quite a bit. Some aspects have only been renamed or moved to a different location in the setup. However, one of the most important aspects of MotoGP has changed in 2021, the physics. If you want to be fast this year, you will need to be smoother. In order to do that, it is now more important to practice than ever before. For MotoGP 21, it is also important to have a different setup for qualifying and the race. This way you can adapt to whatever situation might occur. Let's start with the most obvious part, the tires. Milestone put great emphasis on the calculation of temperatures, and that's why they feel better. While some aspects of the tires are set in stone, there are settings that you can take into your control. Your choice of tire is likely bound to the number of laps you have to drive. At the moment, there are compounds for both front and rear fits best for a race setting, as the aforementioned tire wear is brutal. For time attack or qualifying, the soft compound tire on the front and rear often fits the best. However, on some tracks like the newly added Portimao, the medium tire can also show good results. This only applies to dry conditions, of course. As the game is still in its early stage, slots can change over time. So make sure you to practice as much as you can to stay ahead of the curve. If you want to know more about the basics, you can check out our latest video to get an idea on how to get started in MotoGP 21. If you now take a look at the suspension, we will see that Milestone increased the parameters that are changeable. This allows racers greater flexibility and brings more variety. Now there are clearly two parts to the suspension, front and rear. Starting at the front, there is still the front and rear preload from last year. This determines the height of your bike. Higher value on front preload will mean more grip in the front tires and reduced understeer. A good fixed value is 5 or 6. For the back, I usually go with the standard of 4, but tune it all the way up to 6 on some tracks. There is also the option to add oil to the front now. Increasing that value will stiffen up your front suspension. If you decrease that value, it will make the bike more unpredictable and less stable. While we're on topic, stability is largely controlled by the springs. The setup of the springs is still divided into front and rear as well. The front spring hardness determines how aggressively the spring returns to a neutral position. A good middle ground can be from 2 to 4 here, but again it depends on the track a lot. If a circuit offers lots of bumps, softer springs may be necessary. Something new this year are the options to the swing arm at the front. You can change the compression and extension of it, which will impact the shock absorber. This will make it a main factor in how the bike behaves under braking and acceleration. An increased value here will lead to more stability in general, but can cost you a few inches while accelerating. If you go for a low number, you can overcome bumps and dips more easily. Especially on tracks like Austin or Portimao, where the altitude changes constantly, this can be beneficial. It is important to play around with it and find your best situations. For a bumpy track like Austin, I will go with 3 for the compression and 2 for the extension of the swing arm. Moving on to the rear, MotoGP 21 offers options for the shock absorber. This part is important because absorbers are supposed to keep your wheel on the circuit when things get rowdy. Increasing the values on compression and extension here can give you more grip but can cost you time at certain points on the track. For me, it is more important than ever before to be as smooth as possible, so don't preload the front too much. If you do this, you will run into a stoppie often. Grip onto the back is also important because you lose the bike more easily if you drift into a corner in this new version. While you want to avoid drifting into a corner, you should want to subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss out on any important MotoGP videos on our channel. The gears have been renamed to transmission this year, but stay mostly the same from MotoGP 20. Final drive still determines how fast you are able to race at top speed. A lower final drive means more speed at the upper end, but less acceleration in return. You will need to weigh in if you can make this trade. On tracks with a lot of tricky corners, a eager funnel drive is the king. Tracks with long straights offer the opportunity to run a low funnel drive to be a rocket in a fast section. I will do something between 4 to 6 on most tracks. For the rest of the gears, I use the same approach as last year. You want to prevent a wheelie in first gear and gradually increase the values of the others. The maximum value you can have in MotoGP 21 has been set to 8 instead of 10 this year, which means the first gear should be something between 3 and 4. Something that is brand new is the slipper clutch. This option increases the engine brake force. If you have this number, the corner entries might become more of a misery as the rear can slip right from under you. Are you blowing hot and cold these days? Then you might need to adjust your brakes a bit. The brake options have been limited to 4 for the front and 2 for the rear in MotoGP 21, but are more valuable than ever. In past years I've gone with smaller brakes only in wet conditions and larger brakes in the dry, but this year I feel that on some circuits that require steady control in corners, smaller brakes can be the way to go. This also comes from the fact that Milestone improved the heating of the brakes, which means they get up to temperature easier than before. Smaller brakes can help your year to be smoother in corners, and as I said, smoothness is coolness this year. Something you also have to consider is the nature of the track you are racing on. Smaller brakes can be great on more twisty tracks, while circuits like Mugello might favor the big guns even more. Brakes can be important to everyone's race this year. If you end up with the wrong choice, you can find yourself trailing behind massively or crashing if your brakes overheat. MotoGP 21 is different from its predecessor in a lot of ways. While some options have been reduced, others have been expanded and adjusted to be more like real life. All in all, I can tell you that the standard setup is far better than last year. During the first weeks of MotoGP 21, even many pro drivers will use the full settings and work from there. It is important that you find your groove as much as you can. Practice in time attack and adjust from session to session. Maybe in the future you will be able to give me advice. For starters, it is important to feel the differences that adjusting these parameters will bring. Compared to MotoGP 20, the differences can feel less important. That's why you can experiment a little more. Thank you very much for watching. For more sim racing content, make sure you visit overtake.gg and check out our social media channels. My name is Andrew ZH, have a wonderful day. Bye bye!